Agalave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session of the heat exchangers, we'll try to use analysis LMTD approach. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe overall heat transfer coefficient and derive LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger. Now, before proceeding, we'll see overall heat transfer coefficient, capital U. In the heat exchanger, there will be tube in tube type of the condition, in which through the inner tube, hot fluid is flowing, and through the annular space, cold fluid is flowing. So there will be heat transfer through the wall. Then we required to use one relation, means for mixed heat transfer, the capital U is used instead of small h, that is convective heat transfer coefficient. So this is an enlarged view in which wall is shown. The inner surface is at temperature Ti. Outer temperature is at temperature TO. The wall thickness is this much. So, by means of convective heat transfer, there will be transfer of heat from the fluid to the wall. Through the wall, there will be conductive heat transfer, and from wall to the annular fluid or the cold fluid, convective heat transfer will take place. Now, we will try to see the relation for the overall heat. Here, there are three resistances R1, R2, R3. Consider this radius as R1, this radius as R2. The inner temperature is Ti, outer temperature is To. Inside, convective heat transfer coefficient is Hi, outer is HO. Now, the total resistance will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. R1 is 1 by HI AI. R2 is LN R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL plus 1 by HO AO. As we know, total heat transfer rate is equal to del T by R. Here it is total, which is equal to UA del T. Now, both, if we will compare these two equations, then here UA is nothing but 1 by R total, which can be written as U is equal to 1 by R total into area. And this capital U for the mixed flow heat transfer is known as overall heat transfer coefficient, which is having two different types. If we will consider the inner surface, it will be UI, which will be equal to 1 by R total into AI. And for the outer surface, overall heat transfer coefficient will be UO, which is equal to 1 divided by R into A Kelvin. Now, the typical values are 100 to 350. And similarly, if the steam condenser is there and water is flowing in the tube, the value is 1000 to 6000. So, you will find that for phase change, you try to think about the unit of the overall heat transfer coefficient and also compare it with the unit of the convective heat transfer coefficient. Now, there are two methods of heat exchanger analysis. In the first method, LMTD approach is used, and in the second method, NTU approach is used, number of transfer units. Initially, we will see the LMTD approach. If we know all inlet and outlet temperatures of the heat exchanger, then and then only we can adopt the LMTD approach. We can use the LMTD approach. Now, there are two types of the flows are there, parallel flow and for the parallel flow. LMTD for parallel flow. This is the inner tube. This is the outer tube. Hot fluid inlet temperature, hot fluid outlet temperature. This is cold fluid inlet temperature, cold fluid outlet temperature. For the parallel flow, the direction of both fluids is the same. Then here we can plot the temperature profile. This is THI. As it flows, its temperature will go on decreasing. Cold fluid inlet temperature is somewhere here. As it flows, it will be gaining the heat. So the directions of the both fluids is the same. Now let dq is equal to heat transfer rate. Then for hot fluid it is m dot h cph into bracket thi minus tho, which is equal to minus ch, where capital ch is heat capacity rate, into bracket thi minus tho, which can be written as minus ch into del th. So del th, which is equal to dth, will be equal to dq by ch. Similarly, for cold fluid we can write dtc is equal to dq by cc. Since theta is equal to th minus tc, so this theta is the temperature difference of hot fluid and cold fluid, which is equal to del t. Now differentiating dq, d theta, so d theta is equal to dth minus dtc. Now we can substitute the values of dth and dtc, then we can write it as minus dq by ch minus dq by cc. Here I can take dq common, so it into the bracket it will be ch plus 1 by cc. If we'll simplify this, then we can write d theta is equal to, instead of del q it will be minus u dA, then theta into, let this will be B. Now this theta can be taken on left hand side, so d theta by theta is equal to minus u dA into B. Taking the integration from theta 1 to theta 2, and for this integration 0 to A, because u B are constant. So I can write, I can get ln theta o by theta I, which is equal to minus u b into a. Now substituting the relation for b, which is equal to minus u a into bracket 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. Now instead of this capacity rate, I can write directly minus ua into bracket 1 by m dot th cph plus 1 by m dot c cpc. Since heat transfer by hot fluid is equal to q, which is also same for the cold fluid, which is equal to m dot th cph into bracket thi minus tho. So you can write, instead of m dot th cph, q by thi minus tho, or 1 by mch cph is equal to thi minus tho by q. So we will get ln theta o by theta I which is equal to minus UA into bracket THI minus THO by Q plus TCO minus TCI by Q. By simplifying this equation, we will get ln theta O by theta I, which is equal to UA by Q into bracket theta O minus theta I. So for heat transfer rate, we can write the equation as UA theta O minus theta I by ln theta O by theta I. Now this is also equal to UA delta TM. Now comparing these two equations, UA UA is same, then del TM will be equal to theta O minus theta I by ln theta O by theta I. So this is known as, for further study,